We have heard Paul advising what usually say the young man, Timothy, and the words are, let no one despise your youth. Usually when we give explanation to this particular text, we think that Timothy was a very young man, maybe possibly his 20s or something. Anyway, that is cannot be possible. Because if you know when Paul wrote this letter, that was about 15 years since he met Timothy, was converted. So at least it was more than 15 years. But the word used for the youth, as we have here, is the Greek for the Greek word neotes. And the neotes in Greek is for anybody who is within the military age, which is 40. So it means that Timothy was not more than 40 years. That one we can say for sure. And if they believe that after 40, they are a mature person. So Timothy was not mature, comparing him with his master, Paul, who was a mature person. So Paul tried to let him know that the fact that he's not mature, but it's the standard of where he was, that should not be a thing to let him not do his work well at all. And he gives him just one answer, that he should prove his critics wrong by his conduct. That is all. By his conduct, you know, by what he does, by what he says, people come to know that though he's not mature by age, he's mature in the spirit. I think that's what we are looking for, maturity in Jesus, and maturity in the spirit. So each day we try to grow in maturity towards God. Jesus presented Simon's story in a significant way. Someone invites Jesus to his house. And what does he do? He ignores certain basic rules, basic requirements. And then a woman comes in. Now we know as a prostitute, we usually say. And she comes in and fulfills those rules. Then she goes away better than the man who had invited Jesus. That is something you should be very careful about. You invite Jesus, in the end, you don't gain anything. Somebody was not an invited guest, came in to receive Jesus more than the person who invited Jesus. And that is Jesus for you. You don't need to be an invited guest to take from his blessings. You don't need to be an invited guest to receive from his mercy. Here is this woman who came in. She walks in, uninvited. And yet, she comes to receive from Jesus more than those who were invited. We are here as pilgrims. We are here as children of God. No matter your status, even before men, you know that if you are not welcomed, you are not invited by this woman, show love to Jesus and he will bless you. The same way he blessed this woman and changed her life forever. Her sins were totally forgiven. When you come to Jesus with true love and show him so much love, he has nothing than to take away whatever is our burden. May any burden in our life, may any burdens we are carrying, may they be taken away, so that like this woman shall be free to worship God, indeed, in spirit and in truth. Amen.